everyone. It's Maddie here again with SA Counterculture, bringing you some more cool people of San Antonio. Today in studio, we have the lovely Jill De La Cruz, whose work is also known as Jill DLC Art. Is that correct?
Yes, yeah.
Hi, Jill. Tell everyone hello. So you've brought some of your pieces, which are magnificent. They're very beautiful. Now, let me ask you, I know most of us as kids, we draw, we doodle, we paint, you know, when we're young and that's it. When did your art career really take off?
Well, I'd probably say maybe about like 5 years ago, I started taking it really seriously. Before that, I was kind of just, you know, I would just kind of doodle on my sketch pad and didn't really do anything with it. And then it wasn't until when I went to school for graphic design that I kind of started taking it more seriously and also incorporating the digital artwork along with the oil painting as well.
Okay, so it's a digital background with your own artwork on top.
Yes.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
That is really cool. So now I noticed that all of the subjects of what you've brought in today are female and they're pretty sensual. Is there a reason behind that?
Well, sexy time.
High five.
it's because they're fun to look at and they're really fun to draw and to paint, and I enjoy it, and I'm more familiar with the female form than the male form, and I honestly think it's more pleasant to look at.
That's what I was going to ask next. What's your inspiration? Is there anybody in particular, any other artist or any particular female that maybe inspired you to take that route?
Yeah, actually there's a lot of I'm heavily influenced by a lot of California artists like Amy Soul and Audrey Kawasaki and Camila DeErico. And I'm also, oddly enough, like influenced by like National Geographic and
BBC. Oh, that's awesome.
Earth.
Yeah.
So I'll watch one of those and be kind of like, oh, that's a cool animal. Let me incorporate that in a piece and add on a naked woman.
There you go. You gotta love the combination.
Yeah.
Who wouldn't? Well, your frames, like those are absolutely gorgeous. Did you always present your artwork that way? 'Cause I think it really makes an impact on your presentation. Mm-hmm. So is that something you've always done or just recently started?
I kind of just recently started it. Before, the palettes were the first things that I kind of started doing, and then when I incorporated the graphic design, it's kind of boring just to have it on a plain print, so I would start considering framing my artwork, and I really think it kind of upped it up, you know, a little bit.
It made most certainly did. Yeah, it looks
great. A
little
great. More professional.
Definitely want one in my apartment. Now, do you ever do live painting, or do you only display your stuff at these events?
I just started doing live painting, but I don't really like to do it that much because I'm such a slow painter. I'm super slow with my work, so it'll take me like sometimes a month to get one thing done.
Right.
And I'm kind of like, I have to be in the right state of mind. And but I have done it a couple of times doing live painting, and I actually really enjoy it. I never get to finish my artwork though.
Right. Well, you're
really
probably
fun.
A little bit of a perfectionist,
and
that's awesome. I mean, your work is very detailed and very intricate, so I can
thanks.
See how it can take a while.
Yeah.
You know. Now, if someone wanted to see your stuff, possibly purchase a piece, where would they go to find you?
They can contact me on Facebook. I'm Jill DLC Art on Facebook. I also have an Etsy store online, and I think if you just search in Etsy under Tumble After, it's all one word. But they can buy my prints online. I have smaller mini prints, and then I'm also putting up the larger full-size prints as well. So
awesome. Mm-hmm. Now, y'all definitely have to go and find these pieces, because if not, I'm going to buy that one first. What about any shows coming up?
I believe I have one on the 8th at the Corova for the Art Attack show.
Okay.
Yeah,
8th of June at Corova, downtown Martin Street.
Yeah, I will
definitely
be there.
Check it out. Now, what's your price range for a piece like this if somebody wanted to put up a piece on their wall?
It kind of varies. The smaller palettes, I think I have them marked for $80 a piece. The prints kind of vary. I know this one was 200 framed, and then I also sell it 150 unframed if they just wanted the print and, you know, put it in their own frame. But definitely the oil pieces are a bit more pricier. I mean, this one is probably like 500 maybe.
Yeah, definitely worth every penny. That one is absolutely gorgeous. I'm eyeballing it. So if y'all don't beat me to it, that's going on my wall. Awesome. Well, it was a pleasure having you here today. Oh, thank you. See you later.